So now you have to deal with cool kid hipster Matthew, but before we get into this, as always, don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe so you can see more awesome Alaskan content, just like this. And now, without any further ado, let's jump into this. So without wasting too much time, I'm going to jump right into this. And today, we're going to be talking about my summertime PSK. Now, this is a system I've been running for quite a few years, and it hasn't really changed as far as the pouch goes. Now, this one in particular is the Maxpedition Janus Pocket Extension, but it has been modded out heavily, or not so much modded, but it has been maybe modified, but primarily packed to the fullest possible extent. So starting off, going over what's on the outside, we have a little compass here. This is a Brunton True Arc 3, if I can shove it all the way out. This is a Brunton True Arc 3 little compass that likes to sit in here. It's very tight because this is a very well-packed little kit. But in there, I have my compass. Then turning to the bottom, I still have my little Streamlight Stylus Pro. And this guy is just a little AAA flashlight, and it likes to sit very well at the bottom of my pack. And that provides me with a really good little emergency flashlight should I need it. So then moving over into the internals now, and where this is arguably the most large area, is this, and it's packed up very, very well. And now we're going to go over this. So starting off, I have some paracord just in a little butterfly bundle. Then on the two kind of beginning and end zipper areas, on this end I have a waterproof just bottle kind of ish cylinder of matches and steel wool. I have the steel wool in here, as you guys can see, to prevent the matches from banging around and hurting each other. So I just have the steel wool in there, then the matches there, of course, waterproof matches, and I also have the striker in there for them. So next to that, and this one's actually newly replaced because every once in a while you have to replace your iodine tablets, but got some more iodine tablets here. There's like 40 in here. Then I have the good old knife sharpener, and this is the Spyderco Double Stuff. Still in love with that sharpener. Then what I've kind of done to mix it up a little bit for the bottom is I wrapped my bandana, or I wrapped my Mylar blanket. So you guys see this little orange end. This is actually a Mylar blanket, and I took it and wrapped it up tightly as I could in my cotton bandana. That way these two were not fighting each other for the bottom of the barrel space. So that's what's in the interior, or in the middle. So then off to the right side of the pack, I have my full kind of miniature medical kit here. And with the miniature medical kit, I have some triple antibiotic ointment. So for any cuts, or some, not so much cuts, but for any burns, scrapes, stuff like that, that you're worried about infections, I have, or if I'm worried about infections, I have that. Then I have a whole bunch of different assorted sized band-aids, and a large patch band-aid, and then some just straight up gauze if I need it. So that is kind of the miniature medical kit that I have in the pack. So then next to that, I have two Clif bars, one blueberry, and then I think that this is a, okay, white chocolate, or yeah, macadamia nut, very tasty. But two Clif bars, and I've upgraded that from just one Clif bar. Then I also carry two instant coffees, so it's kind of attached to this. So I carry two different coffees as well. So that's kind of my food and drink there. Then I carry some duct tape, or this is actually the military grade duct tape. It's kind of spooled on a piece of plastic. Then after that, I carry two plastic zip ties, and at the very bottom of this, I carry three safety pins and a sail needle, or a canvas needle. It's a very thick needle, meant kind of for sewing larger threads. So things like I could use natural threads to sew. So that's what's on the right side. Now jumping over to the left side of things, I have a couple lanyards for quick pull. So if I need my ferro rod or if I need a whistle, these are on quick pull. So these can just be pulled out quickly when I need them. I also have a lanyard on my main survival knife. So if I have to pull this out for this pack, not my main survival knife in general, but if I have to pull this sucker out, I also have a lanyard on it so that I can grab it as well. So this, of course, is just a light blue Benchmade 556 mini grip for the main survival knife. So then actually opening this up, I have two little things of plastic bags, and these can be used in a multitude of different ways, but they also are meant to kind of work in conjunction with my iodine tablets so that if I'm stuck out in the middle of nowhere and I need water, I can take all of these plastic bags or one of these plastic bags or whatever, fill it up with water and put some iodine tablets in it and safely treat water without having to boil it. So then next to that, I have two AAAs, so a spare set of batteries for the flashlight, which is kind of important. Then I have a UST wet fire right here. And then I have, and I'm not going to pull them all out, but I have 10 kind of clumped, actually maybe I might be able to pull them all out. So I have 10 kind of clumped together here. These are, man, the name escapes me. These are tinder quicks. Sorry, I could not remember that for like 5 seconds. So I got 10 little tinder quicks all just kind of clumped up in one little corner right there. And then lastly, I have a little spool of probably around 25 feet of tripwire. This is green army tripwire, and that's primarily for snaring. So guys, that is my entire comprehensive PSK setup for the summertime for bushcrafting, getting out in the woods in the middle of nowhere. Like I said, I'm always modifying my PSK from season to season so that it's better equipped, better preparing me for whatever. And this PSK definitely goes on a lot of trips. I'm going to be explaining something here in a few weeks, maybe sooner, but where I actually went into the middle of nowhere, Alaska, and I didn't have to use the PSK, luckily, but it's one of those times that you're sitting there and you realize just how fast a survival situation can kick off, and you realize how nice it is when you have a fully set up, fully capable PSK. Anyways, guys, this is all for now that I have, and as always, God bless, and I'm out.